got the inside line into the chicane though. Can he hold on the brakes? Gets his nose right under his teammate's rear wing. Kerr there on the outside. Oh, and that is a brave move. Right over the curbs on the exit of the chicane. Kerr holds on to that third place, and that was fantastic. And straight away, they've both lost momentum. Everybody's swamping them. And Carbone gets hit from behind by Courtney. Courtney's off into the barrier. He's wrecked the steering. The car's out of control. Oh, and that is a huge, huge hit. Three cars at least involved in that. And James Courtney, you can see the dirt on his helmet. But that is about as big an accident we've ever seen in Formula 3. Mark Mayall and Clivio Piccioni are climbing out of those cars. Heaven knows how. Not really Courtney's fault. He just clipped the back there of Carbone. Then this huge, huge moment. The steering's gone. You can see the steering arm's completely buckled. He's out of control, crawls across the track, clobbered by two more cars. And that was a massive accident. Well, the safety car not surprisingly on track there. You can see the debris, three wrecked cars in the background.
There's Antonucci, and he's right in the back of Austin there. So there's another car in the background now. Antonucci, what was he thinking?
Well, Richard Antonucci there, you can see he's got very heavy front end damage on his car. He was actually gesticulating at Fabio Carbone about something.
And maybe this is the reason why. Carbone's going through the first corner, gets a big clout from Courtney on the way in. And Antonucci there, he had to take avoiding action across the grass. But really, it wasn't Carbone's fault. He was the one who's just on his racing line and gets a hit from behind. Now we look at James Courtney. He goes across the track, over to the other side. And there's a big jump for Mark Mayall. He goes straight into the tyre wall on the right there, and then into Piccioni. Really big jump.